Hey, greetings. This is Maggie with Maggie Motivates, and I have a motivational moment for you. This morning, I am at the Gap House of Prayer, and this place is very special to me. You hear me talk a lot about the importance of physical fitness, emotional fitness, and today we're going to talk about spiritual fitness. Today, I'm at the Gap House of Prayer in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, and as you can see, my brother David here, he's having his coffee and studying the Word of God and spending time, and this is kind of like a seating area where people can come and fellowship, study the Word, read your Bible. There are all kinds of helps available to you. Many people say, I don't know how to pray. Well, there's even aids to help you, like how to pray for 1 hour and different things like that. Each day when you come in, you'll see a prayer focus. And as you can see, today's prayer focus is cultivating a heart of prayer in Middle Tennessee. This is something vital for all believers. Doesn't matter where you're from, what church you attend. And in here, give you a quick tour here. This is the training room. And this is a room where Bible studies go on in here, equipping and training for the saints. There's all kinds of resources available. So maybe you just have an hour and you want to stop by and read a good spiritual book and have a cup of coffee. This is a place to be. And here is the counseling room. And I spend a great deal of time in here. Many of my clients meet with me here on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And so it's a real blessing to me to be able to utilize this space. In addition to that, something that's very near and dear to my heart, there is coffee. Yes, that's right. Coffee is very important. And then here's a sitting area where if you need to have a snack or have a cup of coffee and chat with a friend, maybe even study the Word of God, wherever you're at is great. One thing I love about the prayer room is there's elements. Many times the posture we take before the Lord, as you can see, there's elements available. And now I'm going to take you into a special place. Today in the prayer room, jump-starting the day, is the director, Susan Carter. We have Adam Swanson, who is an amazing intercessor, and we've got the assistant director here, Kim, and they are jump-starting the day. As you can see, they've already got the Word of God out. They've already got their coffee. They're ready to do serious business. So when you come to the House of Prayer, different things are going on. At nighttime, there's live worship available. If you are a musician who desires to connect with the body of believers, contact Susan or Kim to get on the schedule. In addition to that, there is all kinds of resources to encourage you in your prayer life, some instructional things that will help you how to jumpstart and get in a posture of prayer, and give you some more information about that. You know, many people are constantly saying, I just don't know what to say to the Lord. Hey, He just wants to talk to you. You can bring in your personal prayer request. You can pray for your loved lost or your lost loved ones. You can pray for the city. There is several ministries that we pray for on a regular basis here. And Kim developed this board, and it's a prayer strategy, but look at how she's mapped out the availability for prayer. So regardless of what you're doing now in your spiritual life to stay fit, I encourage you to connect with the body of believers. We all go to different churches, but we all believe in the same God. And so today, may you start your day off with the Word and the Spirit, praying and seeking out where you're supposed to be. Prayerfully consider giving some of your time for the House of Prayer to come in and sign up for an hour or two and take sessions where you can just come and study the Word and go deeper and keep that constant flame going. The whole mission of the House of Prayer is to become 24/7. And we would like to invite you to come out, bring your Bible, bring your heart, and seek the Lord. Contact Kim or Susan, and we appreciate you and we love you. Be blessed.